I'm Zuweina, and this is Sarah from Osmania Medical College, and we'll be presenting the case of BARTTER syndrome. A 6-year-old male child who has been developing a history with mother as a lab in Poland came to the hospital with chief protein of two stools in spirals, fevers in spirals, and increased frequency of immunizations in spirals. The child is apparently asymptomatic spirals back, then he developed new stools, 5 stools per day, yellow in color, watery consistency, not associated with blood or mucus, fever of insidious onset, low grade, intermittent, and not associated with chills and rigors. Increased frequency of maturation with 15 to 20 episodes per day. The negative history was taken and it was insignificant. In the past history, there was no history of similar complaints in the past, no history of recurrent infections, and no history of previous hospitalization. Birth history, mother approached case with regular antenatal checkups and all trimesters were uneventful. The child was delivered at full term by NPD with a birth weight of 3.5 kg and cried immediately after birth. In the developmental history, gross motor developmental delay was noted. Child is exclusively breastfed and there is no history of similar complaints in the family. On general examination, child is conscious, alert, completely lying on bed, and there is no evidence of pallor, ictus, cyanosis, choroidal lymphadenopathy, or edema. Head-to-toe examination was done and was normal. Vitals were collected and the child was afebrile with a pulse rate, respiratory rate, and blood pressure in the normal ranges. The child weighs 4.5 kg and the length is 62 cm, both of which are below the third percentile. Weight for height is below third percentile. On systemic examination, on the examination of abdomen was soft with no palpable masses and no evidence of splenomegaly. Serious respiration, serious examination were done and all were unremarkable. Case summary, a 6-month-old male child admitted for diarrhea, fever and increased frequency of maturations in spirals has failed to thrive and there is no evidence of organomegaly. We came to the provisional diagnosis of FGT under evaluation. The details of this case are UTI with filial diarrhea, renal disorder which may include RTA, Bartter's or gentleness, endocrine disorders and inborn errors of metabolism. Investigation, CBP showed normal hemoglobin and a normal cell count. Bacteria and serum creatinine were at the normal ranges and CRP was negative. Stool examination was done and no pathologies were noted. On assessment of serum electrolytes, hyponatremia, hypokalemia, hypochloremia and hypocalcemia were noted. Normal serum ignition was noted. On complete urine examination, urine osmolarity was found to be decreased and urine culture came out to be negative. On assessment of urinary electrolytes, urinary potassium and urinary chloride were in the increased range. Hypercalciuria was established based on increased urine calcium creatinine ratio and increased 24-hour urinary calcium excretion. TTKG value greater than 4 indicated renal loss of potassium. ABG analysis showed compensated metabolic alkalosis. VSG abdomen was done and was normal. 2D echo was normal and ruled out any congenital heart defect. Beta was normal, ruling out any hearing loss. Coming to the ruling of the DDs, UTI with parental diarrhea was ruled out due to absence of a negative, due to presence of a negative urine culture. Endocrine disorders such as hyperaldosteronism was ruled out due to presence of a normal blood pressure. In most of the common inborn errors of metabolism, metabolic acidosis present and hence they were ruled out. Failure to thrive may manifest due to inadequate intake or increased requirement or increased calorie loss. Abnormal urinary electrolyte findings allows the suspicion of increased calorie loss due to an underlying renal disease. A TTKG value greater than 4 confirmed the suspicion of renal loss of potassium leading to hyperkalemia. Hyperkalemia may be present either in metabolic alkalosis or metabolic acidosis. Hypokalemic, hypochloremic metabolic alkalosis may be a manifestation of either Bartter's or Gitelman's syndrome, both of which are differentiated based on serum magnesium and urinary calcium levels. In Bartter's syndrome, we have normal to mildly low magnesium levels and significantly low levels of magnesium in Gitelman's syndrome. And the urinary calcium is high in Bartter's syndrome compared to normal value in Gitelman's syndrome. Hence, based on the investigations, we came to the clinical diagnosis of Bartter's syndrome. The treatment is done by prevention of dehydration by giving oral rehydration therapy, maintenance of nutritional status, correction of hyperkalemia by giving water or 2 milliliters per kg and intermittency. Follow-up is done by using renal function tests. Renal function tests are advised in patients with Bartter syndrome because few of the cases may progress to progressive renal damage and also continued long-term treatment with NSAIDs may cause renal damage. Coming to the take-home message, Bartter syndrome should be considered in cases of failure to thrive with absence of organomegaly. Early ABG analysis and electrolyte estimation should be done. Prompt cost-effective treatment with intermittency can save the child. Thank you.
Problems with pediatric failure to thrive. Mention three common causes of failure to thrive.
Malnutrition.
Good.
Congenital heart diseases.
And
endocrine disorders.
Okay. Can this be fatal? Is this child survived?
Sir, right now there is no definitive treatment. We are treating it because the defect is in the transporter deficiency. So
which part of the kidney?
think a second number of super family. And so there are, maybe we can give a renal transplant, so in that case we can give a normal kidney and that will compensate for the defect in the transporters.
In addition to the failure to carry, what are the symptoms which make you unable to die?
So this case, in many of the Barter syndrome types, there are researches which prove that there is hyperprostatonics.
Symptoms.
So that may
be clinical.
Polyuria.
Very good. Cause of polyuria.
There is loss of sodium and chloride. So due to osmotic effect, water is also coming out. And due to hypercalcemia also.
And is there any treatment which can make them suffer? How many types of water?
There is type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4A and 4B. Initially we used to consider type 5, but we are not now giving the nomenclature of type 5. There is transient Barter syndrome.
Why there is salt craving?
Because there is salt loss, there is hypernatremia and hypochloremia. Sodium chloride is being lost, we are not able to absorb it.
So we clinically ask for salt craving. Salt craving is there as per the mother, the diagnosis comes.
So, one more thing that is pertinent to this study, if you take a test besides hypokalemia.
Sorry, ma'am, I didn't get your question.
Are the other pertinent sign in Barter's to go for investigation? History-wise, it's polyuria, polydipsia.
Metabolic alkalosis is present, hypercalciuria is present usually. Usually we can consider normal magnesium levels, but even mild magnesium testing is also noted.
So how plain the polyuria?
When there is hypokalemia, first initially when it starts with hyponatremia, in the collecting duct there will be sodium hydrogen exchanger also taking place, because of which hydrogen is coming out. So in the normal physiological mechanisms, when hydrogen is coming out, bicarbonate is also absorbed. So that will lead to metabolic alkalosis.
There can be nephrocalcinosis due to hypercalciuria.
What is the role of indomethacin?
Indomethacin is an NSA, nocturnal anti-inflammatory drug. So there are researches which show that there is prostaglandin E. Prostaglandins, they go and cause hyperplasia of the gastrocnemal apparatus, and there is a whole cycle which is causing polyuria. So to prevent those symptoms, they are giving an NSA.
Yes, ma'am.
Renal transplant.